Sledgehammer finally got around to making their blog post about this massive update coming to Call of Duty World War II tomorrow. And this has got me smiling from ear to ear. This is a very, very good update for people who want to be able to earn new content without the fear of always getting duplicates. So let's just hop directly into this update and talk about what they're doing. First off, they're completely overhauling the supply drop system to make it more user-friendly. So let's start off by talking about what they're removing from this game altogether moving forward. So, they're going to be removing gold foil calling cards, and they won't be adding any new pistol grips to the loot pool. If you don't know what the gold foil calling cards are, this is what they look like. It's basically a calling card we already have with a gold border around it. It was just blatant filler. I know I wasn't the only one to call Sledgehammer out on this, and I'm really glad that they're just removing these piles of shit altogether. Honestly, it's not a good feeling to get a heroic and having that heroic just be a copy-paste of a calling card you already have with a gold border. Secondly, the pistol grips have been a running meme of World War II for the past few months. There's going to still be pistol grips, but they're not adding any more moving forward. And speaking of pistol grips and duplicates, let's talk about the fact that they're actually changing the duplicate rate in this game, and they're also going to rebalance the category reward rate. So, first off, they're just reducing the frequency of duplicates right off the bat. That's fucking awesome. Thank you, Sledgehammer. That is really cool, actually. It allows us to get more content without the fear of always getting duplicates. I think this past event with the Resistance was just a shining factor of Duplicate City. It was horrible. Thank you for listening to us and changing this. Another thing that they're going to change is the reward rates for different categories. We're not going to always just see three pistol grips anymore. They're going to actually make sure that each drop we open gives a wider variety. So we might get a nice mixture of gear sets and reticles and camouflages and weapon variants. Oh, yeah, you heard that correctly. They're going to be adding some new categories to the supply drop system. We're going to get weapon charms, camos, and reticles. And like I said in yesterday's video, I'd much rather have these three things rather than pistol grips over and over again. So it's kind of cool to see that they're finally going to be adding something new for our weapons. Customization is very important. And while we're on the conversation of supply drops, let's talk about the new type of supply drop that they're going to be adding tomorrow called armory drops. This is exactly what you think. You're going to be able to use armory credits to purchase supply drops with your in-game armory credits in order to get more content. In the blog posting, it says that these armory drops are going to function a lot like bribes. So does that mean that these armory drops are going to be duplicate protected? I'll make sure to have a video on that tomorrow, so stay tuned. One of the biggest complaints that I had as a creator for all of my subscribers coming out of this last Resistance event was the fact that if you didn't have enough armory credits to complete the collection for the Enfield No. 2 or the Reich's Revolver, you were shit out of luck. They never did special orders for those pistols. Whenever a new weapon is introduced to an online competitive multiplayer game, it's unfair for some people to get it and others not to get it. So it was just a no-brainer to talk about that. And thank freaking goodness, this is what Sledgehammer has to say. New special orders. We heard your feedback on certain weapons being available only in supply drops and how hard they are to get. We are moving these into special orders so that they are easier to access. Thank you. That is all we ask for. And while we're on the topic of earning weapons, they also had more to say. There's going to be more ways to earn weapons. They're going to be offering a variety of paths to obtain the most wanted weapons and weapon variants in-game, as more will be made available via orders and contracts, in addition to existing weapon collections and supply drops. This is awesome, Sledgehammer. Honestly, thank you. This is great. This gives people a reason to grind. This gives people a reason to play. Let's hope they actually get pretty creative with these challenges as well. Seeing it constantly get 50 match completions, yeah, that just causes people to go into lobbies and spin around in circles. Either way, kudos to you, Sledgehammer, for giving us other avenues to get these weapons. And the cherry on top of this thick-looking update absolutely has to be the fact that they're going to be adding more content per update. They're going to be adding new ranged weapons, more cosmetic weapon variants, themed uniforms, commitment to double down on these categories moving forward, so you'll be able to get more of the content that you want. I feel like I literally just said this yesterday. I want more of this game. I enjoy this game. Give me more of it, and this is exactly what they're doing. This is why I'm happy. I don't even care. As long as there's other avenues to earn this and they're not all locked behind supply drops, We're good, man. That's all I gotta say. Just a few closing remarks for this video. Tomorrow marks the start of Shamrock and Awe. This is gonna be the St. Patrick's Day event. We saw this back with Call of Duty Modern Warfare Remastered, and I think that it's gonna be pretty cool. There's gonna be St. Patrick's Day themed gear, and they're doing everything we just talked about in this update tomorrow, so the loot pool and less duplicates, all of that is coming tomorrow. They also teased us with this image showing off a airborne division soldier with a new outfit and a new submachine gun. This is not the Orso, like many people are saying. This is the MAS-38. This is a submachine gun that originated in France. It has a fire rate of 600 to 700 rounds per minute. It's going to be pretty quick, and I don't exactly know how it's going to work in game. Either way, it's cool to see that they teased this, and then last week they teased a new light machine gun, which we should be seeing fairly soon. Of course, I might add on there, this is that camouflage once again in that charm. It's like a little, I guess you would say a top hat with a mustache and a monocle. I'm just going to call that Mr. Monopoly. I think that's pretty dang cool. It's subtle. It's interesting. I'm just looking for more customization, and they're definitely providing it with this update. Once again, guys, I will have a full update tomorrow about Shamrock and Awe. Stay tuned for that video. We'll talk about the armory drops. We'll talk about all this new stuff again and have gameplay of it all and show you guys what everything's all about before you actually decide to spend your armory credits on it. So stay tuned for that. Thank you so much for watching tonight's video. If y'all enjoyed it, drop a like on it. Subscribe for more videos coming each and every day. And thank you, Sledgehammer. Seriously, thank you for being transparent and saying, hey, we fucked up. Screw these gold foil calling cards. We're throwing them in the trash where they belonged originally. The calling cards themselves aren't bad, but the gold foil part, that went a little bit too far. Anyway, guys, thank you so much for watching. I'll catch you on the next video. Peace.